Kyle about that last technique for the throw or the strike. Believe it or not, part of the stimulus money that was used to create jobs was used to study who sweated the most in the United States. And we won, Arizona. And so when you use that technique, particularly in Arizona summer, you grab somebody and they're sweaty, it's easy to lose contact with them. That's why the strikes are there. You're getting ready to throw somebody, if you lose them, and you will lose them, most people in Arizona, because of all the sweat, and you want to hit them quickly. Okay. All right, the last technique we'll do is out of the katas, both katas. Basically, this particular technique, all you're going to do is he's going to come in for a punch. Why don't you do this? From here, try both of these techniques. This one, go for the ear or across the eyes. Or, vary it, use the wrist. Okay? You go for the jaw here. That'll break his jaw. And then he won't be able to talk for a while. Okay, so once in, step back, palm lock, and strike. Okay? Or the sweep with the fingers across the eyes and the ear. This is a great technique to practice. A few years ago, my wife and I were traveling through Grand Junction. We stopped at the IHOP. There must have been 2 million flies in the IHOP. So we had a contest with the people next door to see who could get the most flies in the air. That's a great way to catch them. Great, let's go ahead and try it. It's kind of wimpy at first, but it's very effective. Okay, we're going to use this for, it comes up for a double lapel grab, and then like this, lock, and strike. Okay, and it's very important to get that snap. Use this as a scissors. This should be a focal or an access point where your hands are rotating. The idea here is when you come up like this, you're striking both sides of the neck, and it will knock them out. And it doesn't take a whole lot. So he comes up, just put your hands together, and strike. Well, and you can even move in if you want to. And then he strikes, and down. That'll give you a little bit more force. You can also use it against a kick if it comes in for a kick. And strike. Hey, let's go ahead and try it. Comes in. Just going to interleave here. With your one hand, just like you're knitting or whatever. I'm not sure. I've never done any knitting. Like this, grab the other hand, bring it around. I'm trying to bring his elbows together. I got it. Okay, and when you do this, be careful, because when you do throw somebody with this technique, their feet are going to go over their head. Okay, so again, come in, interleave, grab, make sure you got the elbows like this, pull really tight, and then rotate. And that hurts. So take it easy. If you decide not to throw them, you can use the same technique and hit them. So just come like this, and strike. So try it both ways, so he is going to strike, like this, and strike, just like in the kata. And if you do the throw, maybe we shouldn't do the throw, because it's a pretty dangerous throw, unless you've had lots of jiu-jitsu training. Okay, just bring them around here, pull the arms out, and wind them like that, and you're going to cut it, okay? But again, that hurts. That's okay, you guys got this place we haven't bruised about.